All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sport Chat 503. Thank you guys very much for joining me. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it, man. I try to break it all down. People, college football, NFL, NBA, college basketball, UFC, whatever we got to talk about. Let's talk about it, man. If this is what I'm talking about, the NBA, I'm going to try to break this thing down. I'm pretty much looking at this as the start of week three in the NBA season. It's Friday, November 18th, and I basically just try to break down the top 8, top 10 teams in each conference, and we'll start with the East. The East is led by LeBron James and the Cleveland Cavaliers, and people, they're not disappointing, man. They are running teams. They've lost two games, but for the most part, these guys are on cruise control. You can tell already. They're already looking at the postseason. They're already resting LeBron. LeBron's already trying to say he needs more minutes or whatever. But I'm telling you, this team is going to be ready to go. So let's talk about the rest of the East, shall we? First things first, Atlanta Hawks. Great season. It started off by getting big Dwight. Finally, Dwight's comfortable. Man, you gotta love the fact that the big man's happy. Plus, Millsap is the man. Now you got a real nice 4-5 combo. You got Schroeder as your point guard. Everybody's been loving him lately. And these guys are putting in work, man. These guys are getting buckets. Savalosha's down there. I'm telling you, I like Atlanta. Bazemore. Atlanta's got some players, man. And plus, when you look at Atlanta, they're in that conference that, you know what? Why can't they be top 2, 3, 4? Why not? So, anybody else is up there? Who else is up there? So, you got Charlotte. You got Chicago's playing great. Chicago defensively, rebounding. They're doing great. Dwayne Wade's entered into that team flawlessly. You know, that's a squad you better watch out for. Toronto's a question mark, but DeRozan is balling. DeRozan is just going out of his mind. DeRozan and Harden are the two guys that are just going crazy at the start of this season. And you know what? Toronto's one of those teams that's going to be there at the end. Another team that's going to be there at the end is the Boston Celtics. They're 6-6 right now, but they are playing pretty well. I was watching their game earlier tonight. That's a team that you just don't want to see later on in the season. And that's a team, obviously, as well, that's run for the most part by their guards. You know, their big men are not really the big men of this ain't going to surprise anybody. It's a guard-driven team. And so sometimes you're going to lose those games. Detroit, Indiana, Milwaukee, New York, all those teams are kind of in the same boat to me. Orlando, and then the rest of them, man. Washington's the biggest disappointment so far. I don't know what the hell's going on there, but Washington looks like it's on its ass. And, of course, I'm a Philadelphia 76er fan. Literally, we have two games or 2 days a year to root for. The day that the ping pong balls come out and the day that they pick whoever is going to be the next guy who hopefully will get traded or get injured or something. Anyway, but you know what? You know, you got all credit due. Embiid has looked better. All right, let's do this. West Coast. The West Coast right now is run by, obviously, Golden State. Everybody knows that. And the Clippers. Clippers have the veteran leadership. Clippers have that good outside shooting. Clippers have a lot of depth on the bench. So, I like the Clippers. If they stay healthy, they're in it to win it. And I love that Western Conference Finals of those two teams right there. San Antonio is a team that I think is going to be there at the end, too. But it's still question marks. I don't really know where the ball goes at the end of the game. I don't really know who's the quite general of that team. Obviously, it's Tony Parker, but when you lose Duncan, there's a real like question mark of who's actually leading that squad right now. Obviously, it's Kawhi's team physically, but you know, you're looking at some strange happenings down there sometimes. So they've got it put together. They're still winning most of their games, and they will, but I still don't think that they're going to be that strong of a contender down the stretch. I like the Clippers more than I like them right now. OKC is just balling because you got Westbrook. Westbrook's going for the MVP this year, and hopefully they'll have enough wins for him to be in the conversation, but I don't know if that team's going to survive long term. The team's got some interesting pieces, though. Young pieces as well, so that's a team to watch out for. Lakers are the team that people are love to watch right now. They're young, they're exciting, there's no more Kobe hangover, the shadow is gone. You don't have to worry about is he hurt, is he playing, anything else. They're playing well, and they're just attacking teams. They're young, and they're going with it, and the coach is doing a great job down there, Walton. Memphis is a team that I think is going to be there at the end. They've got the veteran leadership. They know what they're doing. They haven't really screwed that lineup over years. Houston is playing great. Harden is playing great. Triple-doubles almost every night. Tons of assists every night. Even when they struggle, he still does pretty well. Utah, Portland, Denver, they're all kind of in that same zone. Denver's lost more than the rest of those teams. But I still think Denver is going to be in that conversation with those teams. I don't know if all those teams make the playoff. That's the kind of group that's right in that zone that's hovering around that eight spot. Portland's a bit of a disappointment. You'd hope that they were going to play better, but this is a very different team than last year. This is a very different team in the essence that team last year didn't play very well at the beginning of the year, too. They just caught fire in that All-Star break or right after it. So they'll be there at the end. Minnesota, Sacktown, everything else, I don't know. But let's talk about this really quickly. DeMarcus Cousins. If DeMarcus Cousins gets traded, the Blazers should be all in on this one. He's a little bit, obviously, people think he's a head case. I don't think so. I think anybody that goes to Sacramento is going to be half of a head case. You're never going to win. You know you're not going to win. Totally dysfunctional group. You have no idea who the freaking owner is. There's 40 owners. You don't really know who the team leader is. You don't know who the GM is. You don't know who the coach is. They're retreads all the time. They're constant. It's a revolving door there. So if I was DeMarcus Cousins, I'd be half crazy down there as well. But if I'm Portland, I'm all in on Cousins. Cousins and Lillard have a good relationship. That would be a phenomenal 1-2, and I'd give up half the team for Cousins. I think he's that good. In a league where there's no real good big men, I think Boogie Cousins might be one of the best big men, top 2, 3, 4 in the country. I really think you got to go all in on that guy. And you lose LaMarcus Aldridge, and you get guys like Mason Plumlee. You know, this identity needs to have somebody in the middle there that at least takes some sort of shots, heat off the point guards. This team can't win with all point guards, and they can't rebound, and they can't really defend in the paint. So at least you get somebody in there that could do that. It's going to take $1 million to do it, or $40 million or whatever it's going to take. But the whole idea is you can't just trade one guy for him. You'd have to take like 4 or 5 guys, and then you'd have to get maybe 2 guys from the Kings to try to make it match. I don't see it happening, but I think it would be phenomenal for Portland to be able to try to get that done. So that's my spiel, people. Hopefully that happens, and we'll have something exciting to talk about. All right, guys, happy Thanksgiving. Keep on keeping on. Check in with us later on as we go through the year, and I'm going to try to get these out every week, people. Adios.